called in to complain about his wife, who is kind of abusive, and she loses it whenever she gets angry. She shouts in his face, and she was sitting, and she sounded like she admitted that. So I want to tell you one thing in this regard, that once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was visited by a woman, so he asked her whether she is married or not. She said yes. He said, "Adatu zawjin anti, are you married?" She said yes. He said, "Idan unzuri ayna anti min zawjiki, fahuwa innama jannatuki aw naruki." You better be good to your husband, because depending on how you treat your husband, he will be either a cause for you to enter paradise or a cause for you to enter hellfire. Of course, we're not taking things out of context, because the ayah is very clear of Surah Al-Baqarah, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, ayah number 228, chapter number 2. So basically, there are rights and duties on both and for both. But here we're talking about the man whom his wife mistreats him, and she shouts, she screams in his face, and she loses it whenever she's angry. You better understand that this is a major sin. Indeed, it is a major sin. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whenever a Muslim woman offers her 5 daily prayers, fast during Ramadan, obeys her Lord and her husband, as long as he's not asking her anything which is forbidden or beyond her capacity, then she obeys him, it will be said to her on the Day of Judgment, enter paradise from whichever gate you may choose. It's your choice. Enter al-Jannah from any gate that you may choose. But if a woman is abusive, and also if a man is abusive to his spouse, then they did not fulfill their duties towards their amana, the ra'iyya. In the hadith, the man is a ra'in, is a guardian, and he will be asked about those who are under his guardianship, and a woman too, the wife too. So when a woman mistreats her husband, she's blameworthy. Imagine when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, if I'm going to command, or if I were going to order anyone to bow down to anyone, I would have ordered the woman to bow down to her husband. But there is no bowing down in Islam to other than Allah the Almighty. Some people also misunderstand this hadith and say that you should bow down to your husband. No, no, you should not bow down to no one but to Allah the Almighty. Only to Allah the Almighty. But you should be, as Allah the Almighty said, وَعَاشِرُهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, He ordered men to live with them, with their wives, on the basis of kindness and gentleness. Likewise, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, they do have rights similar to those which are due upon them, the duties due upon them to their husbands. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, even though in the hadith he said, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِي, the best of you are those who are the best to their family members, to their wives, to their children. And he said, and I'm the best of all of you to my family. So also, if a woman is good to her husband and is good to her children, fulfilling her duties towards Allah of the prayers of fasting, that is, subhanAllah, husnu taba'uri is equivalent to the reward of observing jihad on the battlefield. This is what a woman came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam complaining about, that only men get to observe the jihad and attend with the Muslim army. What about us? He said, if a woman fulfills her duties towards Allah and she is a good wife and takes care of her duties, is equivalent to all of that. فَإِنَّ حُسْنَ تَبَعُلِ إِحْدَى كُنَّ لِزَوْجِهَا يَعْدِلُ ذَلِكَ كُلَّهُ. So my sister, if you have this bad habit, you better control your anger, and you better understand that simply wipes away some of your good deeds, and you encounter a lot of sins for being abusive, being shouting, you know, all the time to your husband. You should not shout, you should not raise your voice whatsoever.